What's up, people? What's up? Shabby is back. Excuse me, I got a little thingy. Excuse me. Okay, well, a unique opportunity to present itself, so I'm going to keep playing from my last session. So let's just keep on rolling. Keep the party train rolling. Are we recording? We are recording. Okay, I turned up my volume a little bit. I think it definitely could use a little bit more volume. So hopefully I didn't screw things up. That's right. It's sundown. We're in the middle of a blizzard. Everything's fine though. We're all good. Do we have enough water? We have enough water. We'll make it. Got a bunch of water in the farmhouse. Actually, we left a bunch of stuff in the farmhouse. So we gotta basically just sleep here tonight, and then we'll head over to the farmhouse, and then we'll climb down and we'll get into Forlorn Muskeg. Hopefully that'll be a smooth process. We will see, because TLD has a way of making things not smooth, to be honest, so. Alright, I think we should, since we have full health, we don't need to recover anything. I think what we should do is just sleep, and hopefully this storm will abate. So far, not so good. Alright, I think our window is closing. We'll sleep one more hour, and if not, then I'm just gonna wait till the morning. Alright, we're just gonna have to wait till the morning, looks like. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. Okay, we can sleep for 3 more hours, looks like. Pretty cozy back here. We got some good clothes, so I guess pretty much we're out of the danger zone as far as freezing to death in a cave. It still makes me nervous. I still don't like to sleep for big chunks of time. Because I bet we don't even have 25 degrees. Oops. Wrong way. Let's look. They're close. 24. See? I like to be 25. This is the problem. Second pair of thermals. That's the problem. Okay, so now we just passed time. I'm not going to do this entire 4 hours, but we will. Just want to see what's happening. Temperature's great. Look at that. Alright, I'm going to sleep now. We can sleep. Let's let the day, some daylight going. Alright. Looks like it's a pretty day out there. Let me see if I can sleep for another. I can't. Okay. Alright, let's go. Enough of that. Run out of water. I won't be able to take this coal with me. Let's just bring it over to the farmhouse. Okay, alright, let's go. Still pretty bummed that we couldn't find that arrow, but it's okay. I was rewatching my moose hunt, and I actually had 14 arrows, so I think I found all of my arrows. I thought I had 17 for some reason. Of course, we have 13 now, so. Oh, yeah, there was one broke. There was a broken arrow. That's right. So, yeah, we got all our arrows back. There. 14 should be enough to get us through Bleak, especially if I'm using flares to deal with the timber wolves and then have a little surprise for the very, very final Polaroid, which will be Bleak Inlet, but we have to go all the way back through the ravine to get to that section so we can grab our noisemakers. I guess it's not a surprise, I'm telling you. Our boom cans will be used in that final leg, so that'll be fun. Alright, let's make sure there's no wolves. Okay. Let's just pop in here, warm up. Oh yeah, we got water here too, so let's grab some water. Let's get slaked, baby. Get slaked, everybody. Alright, pass some time, warm up. Okay.
Can you eat trees? I'm gonna.
Really? Is that a threat? Are you threatening me, Astrid? No charcoal there. Okay. Let's get a torch out. I'm gonna take a peek over here, make sure there's no sneaker wolves over here. Okay, I'm just listening. Okay. All right, looking good, looking good. Okay, all right, great. I want to get down here to Forlorn ASAP. And keep on rolling with this. Oh, there's a wolf right there. Let's sit and avoid him. Don't want no trouble with you.
Whew. Sure getting cold.
Give me three steps, wolfie. Throw weather is go weather. You know the old saying. So let's go. I need to warm up real quick. I'm gonna get a little bit more food. I want to, we have to sort our gear because we're carrying too much right now. Probably coal. That's probably the culprit. The culprit, get it?
It's so cold.
Oh man, I got a million of them. That was terrible. That was absolutely terrible. Culprit, oh my god. Okay. All right, let's drop all our sticks, because, you know, you can always get a stick. You can always get a stick. So there's no sense in... Let's look at our torches. You can always make a torch, which is essentially a stick, if you think about it. Okay, let's drop all these guys. We don't need them. Might drop a couple more. Oh, we got... Okay, look at our weight. We're good. We'll take one accelerant. Just in case there's like a bear problem. We don't really... Man, this jerry can's heavy. I think it's like almost 2.5 kilos. I say we grab some coal. Alright, obviously we're gonna have to drop some more. But that's... I mean, that's it. We don't have any water in that cave down there, but that's okay. Do I have both pots? Can I grab both pots? Yeah, we have both pots. Alright, we're gonna eat our way out of the situation. This is enough water to get us down there. And we can make some more in that cave. God, look at all this stuff in here. Just a bunch of fuel. It's strewn about. Very messy. Very messy, Shabby. Alright. Let's drink this. Get it out of our inventory. We'll eat a bunch of cattails. We can grab some more in the basin. And, not a bunch, but I want to grab some birch bark. We'll also grab cattails over there. And, we might have to rest a little bit in the cave. But then we'll go. Alright, we still are too heavy. I have too much coal. Let me drop some coal. Drop that. 20 coal, that's a lot. 15. I've noticed I am pretty bad about... I carry way too much coal. I do like coal, obviously. But, I do probably carry more than what's really necessary. Bedroom pot check. Let's go, baby. Let's get out of here. I'm so excited about wrapping this whole thing up. It's been a blast. I'm so happy that this has been the last thing of... kind of the last big thing that I've done before it's all over with. This is just kind of a personal thing, I guess. No one really cares about Polaroids, so this is really just kind of a thing for me. Although, really, it's kind of a guide to Interloper, I think. I know it's not explicitly that, and I think a good guide would be one episode with several tips that are, you know, provided in that one episode. You don't need to watch someone play a bunch of Interloper to get all those tips. They're hidden. There's hidden gems, but they're so hidden, much like the Polaroids. So, I don't know. I guess I'm just saying I don't really know who this is for other than me, but I hope people enjoy it. I'm having a blast. I try to make jokes and have fun along the way, and so I hope people are enjoying it. The handful of people that are actually watching these.
Did I hate being cold, because I really do.
I think you've mentioned it a few times. Okay, let's get in here, warm up. Weather's nice, I don't want to sleep. I'd rather just keep on rolling. All right, that's good enough. Let's keep going. Okay, here comes the snow. Which is fine. We'll be able to find our way to the cave. So that's where it's going to get worse. I feel like it's probably just going to turn into full-on blizzard, but we can get over to the cave pretty easily. And then after that, then we can go do a little birch bark hunting. And then we'll head out. You guys are lucky I have a bunch of moose meat waiting for me. Old time's sake. Can't help it. You don't know how hard it is for me to pass up some mushrooms. There was some up by the house, and I was like, look at those mushrooms sitting there. They just look so inviting. I just want to pick them. Got the chill music. Love it. Hey, here we are. Let's put this away, or it annoys me. Okay. All right, let's warm up. I love it when those violins kick in. That's the best. Okay, let's sleep for an hour. Let's see what the weather's doing. Okay. Alright, let's go over here. Let's get our think about it. Like you can hear the sounds of wearing the crampons, so it's a good reminder. This is kind of unnecessary, but now that we know that we have all the arrows, I'm less motivated to do this. I do want to get a little bit more food for the road and have an ability to recover health if we really need it. Because we are going into Timberwolf country pretty soon, so I want to be ready for that. Alright, well, let's go on up here. Check real quick. Probably walking right past it. There we go. Where are you, birch bark? Birch bark, birch bark. Gosh, okay. I was looking at a map the other day. It was said, it was showing the parts of the country where people say dang. You can imagine. It was just the south. It was just a bit, it wasn't Florida. It was all the south except for Florida. And then like little parts of Kentucky, which that's where I'm originally from. So I just said gosh. No one really says gosh either. But a lot more people say gosh than dang, which I do say dang. You can even say gosh dang if you really. For those people who really don't want to say anything possibly offensive, you can say gosh dang. Okay. Alright, we'll pick a couple more. Let's just don't need to do this. Now should I go for 69? that's so childish. Okay. Let's head back to the cave. One second I'm saying gosh, the other second I'm saying 69, so who knows? I don't know. Try to keep up. Alright, let's put that away. I guess we should just sleep for an hour. We got water. Okay, we got a little bit of water. We got food. I'm not going to cook that stuff up. Gosh, I kind of could just keep going. Let's warm up. Let's sleep. I don't know what's going on. I can't make up my mind. Okay, pick it up. All right, we'll grab the water, grab the food, grab a little bit of fuel.
Man, this pack is getting kind of heavy.
Okay, getting late in the day. We can sleep in that Hat Creek cave if we need to. I'm not sure if we're gonna have another wolf floating out here. I'm gonna go over to this hermit cabin because there might be some peaches over there. We're on a peach rescue mission. That was actually what this whole thing was all about. Man, that deer looks so cool. Oh, sorry, I was drinking. I couldn't point my camera over there. Just the way that deer was looking was neat. There's a wolf. Okay, let's see if we can scare up a deer going that way. Because we are riding dirty right now. Oh. Oh boy. Oh man. Oh, he's stuck. He's stuck. Oh, I'm stuck. Okay, he's going straight for the wolf right now, so hopefully, fingers crossed. I mean, it's really just going to save us a match, but hey, match is a match. Bunch of coal here. Let's just look.
This will come in handy.
Gosh, I just don't need it. I don't need any of this stuff. I guess the peaches would have probably disintegrated by now if they're in here. So... Ooh. Okay. Alright. Oh, he did kill the deer. I wasn't paying attention, but I didn't hear it kill it. I'm just gonna let him go. Just let him go. We're not coming back through here. We'll just let nature take its course. Yeah, so I think it's going to be Hat Creek Cave for us today. Can't think of anywhere else that makes sense where we'd sleep tonight, even though it's still fairly early. I guess if the weather were not, if it weren't flurrying out, I would be more, I'd be more persuaded to try to get all the way around to the other cave that's by the broken, there's a cave by the broken tower where there's a Polaroid possibility. That's where I would go to, but with the weather like this, I just don't want to, I don't want to risk it. It's unnecessary. We've already checked this cave, this little alcove here. We've already looted it. I'm not even going to show you. You can go back and watch that one if you're interested. I came over here to hunt the moose a long time, way back when. And it wasn't there. So then I just came over here and grabbed and tried to look for the Polaroid, but it wasn't there either, so. Just thinking for a sec. We have a lot of energy. If the weather were nicer, I'd do it, but let's just... This is boring. We would have three steaks. We'd have three moose steaks too, though, so. I'm just gonna pass time. And just see what the weather's like. Let's just go out and look. Say we go. I say we go for it. I'm gonna drop this moose meat though. I don't want to be traveling through there with moose with stink. Grab a steak, right? You can grab a steak. One steak.
I'm not sure I can carry much more.
Oh really? That was it, huh? Okay, so the first place we need to check is low blind, which is right below this ridge. Hey, don't forget about your birch bark, folks. This is good. This is another really good spot for birch bark. This is just a overall just good spot for foraging purposes. If there's no moose up here, you can just free reign. You have no danger. There's shelter with that cave. Lots of birch bark, lots of mushrooms, rose hips, rabbits, deer carcasses. There's a stem up here. It's a good spot. Very good spot. And no wolves. Have to point that out too. This could be a dumb decision on my part. Mainly because we have to go to that bear cave, which it's a little. I don't know if I mean, I know kind of where it is. I know it's in that little sort of, there's an arch spot, and I think it's right. It's like there's an island, a rock island, and the bear cave is just like on the south side. It's on the other side from where we are now. I don't know what direction that is though. Alright, so let's head down this way. Let's keep our eyes peeled because there's definitely wolves around here. But we'll head down to the low blind. I'm hearing wolf crunchy sounds. I just might be paranoid though. Okay, there's the low blind straight ahead. I got a good feeling about this. Like this is gonna pay off for us. I know there's only a few more spots. There's two Polaroids, and there's probably, I think there's three places left to search. Possibly four, but I think it's three. No, there's four. I think there's four. There's four. Yeah. Okay, oh, there it is. Bingo. Sweet. Some wandering last winter took me to the strangest, most desolate part of Great Bear. Looking out over the broken marshland, I couldn't help but think of you. What a time we had. See. Sweet. Okay. We don't need that anymore. Beef jerky.
Okay.
Got some jerky. Okay. We need to hustle. We need to hustle. Run out of daylight. I gotta get over here to this bear cave, and then we can climb. And then we can go up to the... Once we get past the bear cave, I'm gonna feel much, much better about this. So we don't have time to grab cattails. We just gotta hustle. We gotta hustle. Without running. I want to save my, energy just in case things get bad, so I don't want to use that up yet. And it's warm, too, so there's no reason to, run to conserve our health, which is also it's a pretty legit reason to run, is by, see, there's the arch straight ahead. So I think the rock outcrop on the left of the arch, that the bear cave is in there, or on that rock outcrop. But I think on the other side. We'll find out. I guess we'll find out. Don't ask me where the wolves are. I have no idea. I fully expected to run into some, but... Need to get up there where that log is after we do this. And I think, okay, we looks like we can get up there this way. That's good. There's a wolf over there. Not a problem. Really like to know where the bear is though. Okay, he smells us. I don't know why he's not barking. Here he is. Okay. Right, let's take him out. Oop, that was a bad job, but we got him.
I can drop any of this gear.
All right. I think is the bear? I hope the bear cave's not over there somewhere. But I thought it was... There's the bear in front of us. I thought it was on this island. Okay, he's coming at us now, so he must smell our moose meat. Hmm. Coming across the ice, he is, okay. I'm just gonna go around this way to check before I go up. Okay, wait, here's his tracks. Okay, here we go, here we go. Alright, got it. Alright, let's run in here because we're running out of time. Alright, I do not see a Polaroid in here. Okay, alright, let's go. The bear moves slow and fast. If you're not looking, if you're not watching it, it moves really fast. Somehow. Okay. Let's see, how do we get up there? I think over this way.
Oh, it's getting dark out here. Time to look for for shelter.
Yep, that's what we're doing, Astrid. Good idea. Good thinking. Good thinking, Astrid. Okay, so we just need to... So now we're walking over the arch. We're on top of the arch. And we're going to go up there to where that log is. And then we can just work our way around the edge to the cave. Should be good. I believe this log you have to get on it from one side. I can't remember this side. Yeah. Alright. We're doing it. We're doing it. I'm not sure where you I think you map the Polaroid here at this broken tower as well, the one that we got. I'm not 100% sure about that. Look at that flag sticking out on that, and then it'll go down. There, it went down. There's a few pesky wolves that hang out around here, but there he is right in front of us. Here he comes. Oh, he got scared. He's like, what's that smell? It smells good. Oh my gosh, get out of here. Right, and this is the other Polaroid spot. Accelerant, some fuel. I think it'll have a suitcase. I think that's the way it's described. So let's we need some water. So let's do that. Okay, things are good. Things are good. Okay, I gotta pause for just a sec. Okay, and we're back. Alright, what to do? We have one charcoal left. I need to figure out where this thing maps. Way over there, huh? I think that's up by the Bleak Inlet Cave. We might have to actually, because I think the other one's at the Broken Tower, so I think we might have to come back. Let's read what the, let's look at the Polaroid and then read it. So he says we have, there's 15 total Polaroids. It just never got updated from BlackRock. Okay, yeah, there's a gate here, or a fence, so that's the other spot. That's the other spot, by Bleak Inlet Cave. Just past it. We'll do that while we're when we're leaving. So right now, let's just settle in. We'll make some water. We got full health, so we don't have to worry about recovering. So we just need to rest. That's it. Throw our wood on there. I didn't pick very many sticks up, did I? Alright. I say we sleep for... Maybe we can sleep for 2 hours? Will this let us sleep for 2 hours? Probably. Let's do it. I think we can do that without boiling our water over. We'll see. Okay. What we got on the fire? Almost 4 hours still? Okay, that's good. That's good. No complaints here. It's a nice, clear, but windy night. Okay, no need to make water now. We got plenty of water. Let's see. Torches. Let's get some torches. To sleep. Let's go ahead and get rid of all our stink, hopefully. I don't want any wolves wandering in here. Because that one wolf, it does kind of come close to this cave. It patrols pretty close, so. Just don't want any accidents to happen, you know?
Not sure I can carry much more.
I hate to be waking up by a wolf eating you. It's not a great way to wake up. Some good torches here. Of course, this one will be... Oh, it's okay. Alright. Okay, let's sleep. I'm gonna move to the back just to avoid any wolf problems. I don't know if that helps, but it makes me feel a little bit safer. I think we can safely sleep for 3 hours. Sun's up. Looks like it's a kind of a windy day, though. We probably could get a mag lens right now, but we don't need to. So let's pass an hour. Let that sun come up. Let it get a little bit warmer out there. Ooh, it's still nice. Still kind of windy. Alright. Do a little food assessment. We're good. Let's just sleep for an hour. And then we'll go. We have to search the bunkhouses over by Spence's farm, and I think that's the last possible place. So, yeah. So hopefully it's there, and if it's not, then we missed it somewhere, or I'm forgetting something. You know what? I'm gonna go back over here. We'll make a mag lens, and then I will, make a mag lens. I'm gonna make some warming up tees.
Come on, little fire. Come on.
Don't jump in the fire, Shabby. Come on now. Okay. I mean, let's make a birch bark. Why not? Pulling out all the stops, folks. There's some big T's in there. Forgot about that. Oh man, we did not a good tea dump. Not the best tea dump in my career. My tea dumping career. Wow. Terrible. Terrible. Okay. Picking up all the small ones. I want to drink a big one. There's a big one. There's another big one. Okay. Alright. So. Should I just drink it now? We're not really slaked. We're overly slaked, folks. We're too slaked here. Let's drop some, I think we have a lot of torches. Drop our crappy ones. Have that many crappy ones. Not as many as I was thinking. Alright, let's go. Wow, look at this weather. This wind slash wolf problem. Might have to do this torchless. He just behind one of these trees? Where is he at? Oh, he's up there. Holy crap. Okay. Alright. I'm just trying to find a nice area to do this. Do the dirty business. Not the best shot, but still did it. Okay, now we can drink a tea. Let's drink a tea. Hot tea. Where's my big teas? There they are. Overly slaked now. Torch go out? No. If you're ever looking for mushrooms, this is the place to go. You can walk all along the southern part in this map and just go to town on mushrooms. So up there is a Polaroid possibility. We've already searched it. I don't know the exact spot. So, your mileage may vary. You just have to go up there and just poke around. And I don't know. That's all I can say. It's just up there somewhere. And it did say it's in a dip. So let's just see what we left. I'm just curious. It's in a dip, so you have to be kind of above it to see it on a higher elevation, looking down. So that's all I got for you on that. So good luck. I think we did a pretty good job of searching, so don't think we missed it. At least, maybe I'm just being optimistic here. Alright, let's go ahead and take it out. We got a torch, the weather's nice, let's just do it. Okay, alright. Equipped. Oh, my teeth are cold. Waited a little too long there. That was probably like 20 seconds. Okay, so around here somewhere, I don't know. Hopefully it's in a container. Those would be easier to see. But if it's not here, I don't know. I'm not sure what to do then. The book? That's weird. Oh, here's the suitcase. I've never noticed that. Yes! Wheat. Let's read it. These lousy towers keep me so busy, I snapped a picture just for you. This is what keeps me away from home all these weeks, but I'm almost done. L. Okay, so this is the broken tower. So, let's go back to the broken tower. That makes the most sense. And I'm going to stop there. I'm actually going to stop in that cave. And then we'll map on the next. Maybe we'll map. I don't know. We'll see. I don't want to have to backtrack later after I leave Bleak Inlet, so what we'll do is, after we do the broken tower, we will head into Bleak Inlet, and then search all the spots in Bleak Inlet, come out, map the second Forlorn Muskeg Polaroid, go into Mystery Lake, and then on over to the ravine, and then down to Bleak Inlet. And that will be it. Getting really close now. Only took about, I don't know, probably 50 episodes or so. Probably more than that. Probably like 55 episodes is what's going to end up being. I'm on 40 right now on YouTube. And the last one I just posted was Leaving Blackrock. So that's how far behind I am. Probably about, I don't know, probably about a week behind. Okay. And we're back. I was almost done anyways, but had a little interruption. Alright, so let's just run over here. Weather's nice. I gotta think about it like I'm not ending the day. I'm just ending the session, so I want to have myself set up for continuing to travel, etc. I think what I might do, let's just do this, since the weather's nice. Oop. And this is, see, this is the kind, I just don't want to, I don't, if I weren't quitting right now, I'd just be doing this, but now I'm annoyed by it. Because it's another chore we have to do. But, you know, hey, that's what this game's all about, doing your chores. I would like to see a breakdown of time spent doing activities. If Zach were ever going to do a video, if he were going to take a request, that would be my request. I would like to see percentage of time doing activities. Because I think cooking, I would like to see how much time is spent cooking, how much time you spend sleeping, how much time you spend traveling, all that stuff, because I would like to see a breakdown, because I bet cooking is a huge, huge part, at least in the early game, and then it would, then you could look at it, break it down by, like, you know, phases of the game, because you probably do a ton of cooking at the beginning, and then less as you move along. Just interesting. I don't know. I'm curious about that. So I'm going to warm up real quick and run over here and map. Looks like it's right by the base of this. Something like this, or here, or something. Hang on, let's see. Let's look at the... Dang it, come on. This one. Yeah, it looks like you're standing, like, right here. Right here, or something. But you're probably out. The vista is probably just out here somewhere. Let's just walk out here. Walk along the edge. Might be too foggy to do this. Trying to find that cue. Come on now. You just gotta be in front of it here. Hmm. It's weird. Okay. Well, maybe it's not this tower. I thought for sure it was this tower. There's another tower that's on way, way on the north side. I was just reading the Polaroid and it looked like it was describing a broken... I honestly don't know how one person would be able to fix that. So. Alright, well, I'm gonna run in here. I'm gonna run in here and save it. Sleep for an hour. We'll save it. And then I'll figure it out. I don't know. Maybe it is the other tower. And if that's the case, then that's gonna suck. But we'll do it also on the way out. We'll do on the way out. That's just all we can do. I'm not even gonna save my fire. I don't care. Okay. All right, folks. Well, it's been a blast again. We'll see you next time. Take it shabby, everybody. Okay, I did that a little early, didn't I? Okay, now take it shabby.